Hello, this is Bill Brown, and this is the Guitar by Ear mini lesson called Guitar Basics. What we're going to talk about in this lesson are the terms that we use in the Guitar by Ear lessons. We're going to learn about strings, frets, the term up a string, down a string, up a fret, down a fret, slides, hammer-ons, pull-offs, how to hold the pick, downstrokes, upstrokes, finger numbers, and basic finger-picking technique. And this will give you the basic skills you need to start using some of the Guitar by Ear lessons. If you're new to the guitar, I would recommend using a lot of the level one beginner level lessons and then work your way up from there. So let's talk about strings. When we count the strings, we start from the floor. So the skinniest string is string one. The one above it is string two. The one above it is string three. Next will be string four. The one above that is string five. And then the top string, the thickest one, is string six. If we talk about going down a string, we're actually going from a literal up to down. So the top string, sixth string, if I were to play it and go down a string, that would put me on the fifth string. Down a string from there would be the fourth string. Down a string from there would be the third string. And down a string from there would be the second. And then finally, down a string from there would be the first. And so the opposite is true if we talk about going up a string. So if I'm on the first string and I go up a string, I'll go to the second string. Up a string from there is the third string. Up a string from there is the fourth string. And then up a string from there is the fifth string. And then finally, up a string from there is the sixth string. Now, the frets are those spaces that are created on the fretboard by the wires. And those wires are called the fret wires. Whenever we hold down a string, we don't want to hold it right on the fret wire. We want to hold it in the space created by the fret wire. So if I were on the first string and I wanted to hold down the first fret, it should sound like that. So I'm pressing down on the first string in the first fret. And the first fret is the fret that's furthest away from your body. It's one right up there at the very top of the guitar where the strings break across what we call the nut to go to the tuning knobs. So that's the first fret. Try to use the tip of your finger whenever you're holding down the frets. So if I were to hold down the second fret, it would sound like that. And then the third fret. So we start counting the frets furthest away from your body, right there where the nut is. That would be your first fret. If you go towards your body, up a fret, that would be the second fret. And if you go up a fret from there, that's the third fret. If you go up a fret from there, that's the fifth fret. So when we talk about going up, we're actually going higher, coming towards our body, and that makes the pitch of the string higher. So that would be up a fret. So consequently, down a fret would be going the other direction. So let's say if I were holding down the first string fifth fret, and I wanted to go down a fret, I would go there to the fourth fret. So when we're talking about frets up and down, we're talking about changing the pitch of the note. So going up a fret makes it higher, while going down a fret makes it lower. Now let's talk about what we call slides. If I'm already on a note, let's say the third string, second fret, and if I want to slide, what I would do is I would hit the note and then move it, in this case, higher. I moved it up to the fourth fret without striking it again. So I'm only striking the string once, in this case with my pick, and then while pressing down on that note, sliding it up two frets. Now we can also slide down. Let's hold down the fourth fret, hit that same note, and then we'll slide it back down to the second fret. And that's a slide. And we use slides a lot in playing lead guitar, like a slide. The other technique we use a lot is called a hammer-on. So a hammer-on is when we hit a string like usually open, and then we'll hammer the tip of the middle finger down, in this case, onto the second fret. So I'm hitting the fourth string open, and then without striking again with a pick, I'm hammering the tip of my second finger down in the second fret on that fourth string, and it creates a tone. You can also use a hammer-on with two closed strings, and that means they're not open. For instance, here's a hammer-on from the fourth string second fret to fourth fret. So I'm holding down the second fret of the fourth string, and I'm using my first finger. I'm going to hit that, then while keeping that finger down, I'm going to hammer on the third finger on its tip to the fourth fret of the fourth string. And once again, I'm doing that without striking the string again. And that's called a hammer-on. Now, the opposite of a hammer-on is what we call a pull-off. Here's one. Now, what I'm doing there is I'm holding down the third string, second fret, and I'm using the second finger. I'm going to hit it, and then I'm going to pull that finger off while plucking the string a little bit. So I actually pull down on it. And what happens is that as the finger comes off, it plucks the string open. So I'm not striking the string again with a pick. All you're hearing there is that one finger pulling off and creating a tone. And of course, you can do that with closed strings as well. In this case, I'm going to hold down the third string, second fret with finger one. But I'm going to start off, though, with my third finger on the fourth fret of the third string. I'll hit that, and then I'll pull it off. And what you're hearing is that first finger waiting there on the second fret. So I'm pulling off to that second fret being held down with the first finger. And that's called a pull-off. That's a combination of hammer-ons and pull-offs. Now let's talk about holding the pick. When I hold the pick, for the most part, I'm using the top joint of the index finger and the top joint of the thumb. The index finger is holding the back side of the pick, and then the thumb is on the front side. And I'm also bending that index finger so that what I'm getting on the back side of the pick is a strip of flesh made by that upper tip of the index finger. And then on the front side of the pick, I've got this strip of flesh being created by the thumb. And so the pick is being braced at the top by a strip of flesh from the thumb on the front and a strip of flesh by the index fingertip on the back. And it makes a real stable platform to pick from. And you can strum with that. And also you can pick with it. You can pick real fast with it, actually. Because what happens when I'm picking that fast, it's almost like I'm rubbing the string with the tip of the finger. And I can do that simply because of the way that I'm holding the pick. It's a real stable way of holding the pick. So start there. Now, when we talk about downstrokes and upstrokes, a downstroke of the pick will be if you're coming from on top of the string and then striking it downward towards the floor. An upstroke is the opposite. Your downstroke and your upstroke. Now let's talk about finger numbers. In the hand that actually frets the guitar, the index finger is called finger one. The middle finger is called finger two. The ring finger is called finger three. And then your pinky is called finger four. The thumb is just called the thumb. So in your fretting hand on the guitar, and if you're a right-handed guitar player, that should be your left hand. Of course, if you're a left-handed guitar player, it will be your right hand. But fingers 1, 2, 3, 4, and the thumb. With the other hand that's holding the pick, whenever we decide to do finger picking, we refer to these fingers as the thumb, the index, middle, ring, and little finger. Some of the classical books you might run across, they'll have the thumb indicated as the letter P. And then they'll have the index finger as I, middle finger is M, your ring finger is A. That stands for annular, which is like a ring. And then your little finger is C. That's for culpa. Now, a lot of modern guitar books will also use the banjo notation for these fingers. And so for the thumb, you'll see a T, like a lowercase T. For the index finger, you'll see one dot. For the middle fingers, it's two dots side by side. For the third finger, you'll see three dots in a triangle shape. And then for the little finger, your fourth finger, you'll see four dots in a square shape. And that's banjo notation, and you'll see that sometimes in your guitar notation as well. But I will refer to them as the thumb, index, middle, ring, and then your little finger. And that way we'll have one set of labels that are unique for each hand. Because for the picking hand, thumb, index, middle, ring, little finger. But for the fretting hand, fingers 1, 2, 3, 4. And if we need the thumb to reach around the back of the neck, we'll just call it the thumb of the fretting hand. The only other thing I need to cover here is just basic finger picking technique. And what we like to do is when we're using the thumb, we like for it to take care of the sixth string, the fifth, and the fourth. Then the index finger will take care of the third string, and the middle finger will take care of the second string. And depending on the song style, that middle finger will also take care of the first string. But you can also let your ring finger, if you're doing like an arpeggio. And what I'm doing there is the thumb is hitting the sixth string with a downstroke. I'm hitting the third string with the index finger with an upstroke. And to do this, I'm using the tip of the finger, and I'm plucking the string so that the finger moves towards the palm of my hand. Try not to let your hand move. Make the finger do all of the work. For that second string, I'm using my middle finger to pluck towards the palm of my hand. And then I do the same thing with the first string, using that ring finger to pluck the string towards the palm of my hand. And those are the basic things that I wanted to cover in this little short lesson that would familiarize you with the terms that we use in our guitar by ear lessons. So once you feel like you have a grasp on these basic techniques, go pick you out a lesson and start learning to play your favorite songs by ear.